duplicate unpairedness, see how we did for diode. Same logic we will use. Okay. How is my diode complete this part? We are given. Duplicate unpairedness, see similar logic we will use for the voltage divided by our circuit. So what we did there, first we will take the, first we will do DC load line, okay? What we do in DC load line? Simple. We take the DC equivalent. Output loop will write the KVL equation. Right? That equation will get the form of straight line. Okay? Hence, it is called as, and it is related, okay, there is a load term line, hence it is called as DC load line. Same logic. Right? So, first we will go for DC equivalent. What is the DC equivalent for voltage divided by us? Okay, you know this already. Four resistors, one transistor. Right? This is the DC equivalent circuit. What is this resistor? Hello. What is this resistor? R. This one?
R.
This one?
R.
R. And B. Okay. So this is the DC equivalent for voltage divided by R. What can you call this current as? IC. C. This one? I is here equal to I replace IC, but okay, I is equal to IV plus IC. What you can neglect among this? What you can neglect? Base is lightly doped and very thin, because of which base current will be less. Okay? I told long back, if you forget and come, then how they will progress. So you can neglect. So this is nearly equal to I C. Okay? Now write the KVL to the output loop. So in the KVL equation, Bharat. Stand up. This is equal to. Tell me the KVL equation. Very good. ICRC plus here you have to label. Okay? This is collector, base, emitter. You have to label this multimeter B, C, E. Here? Right? In the part. You are coming across collector, emitter, so BC, sit up. So, plus BCE plus, tell me, sit and tell, next word. R into I. R into I can say IC, right? So, I will take it as IC into R. Okay? Right? So how can you write this as? You can write this as IC is equal to, okay, IC comes, I will bring on one side. IC into two IC terms. Right? Will be equal to what? Will be equal to minus DCE. Correct? Two IC terms, we are keeping on one side. Remaining DCE, I am sending to the other side. Clear? Now I say to you what? Minus 1 by RC plus RE into BCP plus BCC by RC plus RE. Right? Corresponding line RC plus RE on the other side. We are getting this. Then, which characteristics you have to consider? For this bias already been. Which characteristics you have to consider? Common base, common emitter, common collector. Which one? Common emitter. I told you. Common emitter configuration is widely used because gives high current gain, high voltage gain. Means high power gain. Current into voltage is power. Okay? It gives high current gain, high voltage gain, hence high power. Hence it is widely used. This is also common collector, enters towards ground. All the biases we have considered common collector. Common emitter. Okay? Common emitter is towards ground. Fixed bias also emitter was grounded. Common emitter. Okay? Collector to base bias also emitter was grounded. Common emitter. By default, all the biasing circuits we have considered common emitter configuration only. So which characteristics we will consider? Common emitter characteristics. KVL did we apply to input loop or output loop? Here we have applied KVL. Okay, KVL to the collector emitter loop, output loop, right? Not at the input side. So which characteristics we should consider? Output characteristics or input characteristics? Which one? Output characteristics. Okay? So what is the output voltage? VCE. What is the output current? IC. Right? Okay? So that is the reason we are taking same fixed bias also, we have taken output characteristics of common emitter configuration. We did load line. Okay? Output characteristics of CE. Okay? Output characteristics of common emitter configuration, and how will the characteristics be? Like this. Okay? Right? So what is x-axis? So this is the x. Right? What is the y-axis? So this is the y. Again, same logic what we did for diode, what we did for fixed bias. Okay? Then, so this is in the form of what? Well, y is equal to? This is y, so this is constant. Constant, this is also constant. Right? So y is equal to constant into x plus constant. So it is in the form of same point that we got for previous case. Okay? Call this equation 1. Equation 1 is in the form of y is equal to mx plus c. Okay? Right? So it is a straight line. Right? Again, same logic, same point. How to get point on x-axis? Well, put y is equal to 0. Right? Okay? How to get point on x-axis? To get point on x-axis, put y is equal to 0. Okay. So, what axis I should call now? all x axis. I will call BCE axis put IC equals to 0 in equation 1. Right? So if you put IC equals to 0 in equation 1, what is the point you get? BCE will be equal to what? You can see and tell. If we put IC 0, BCE will be equal to what? Do. 10 times by 12, do it. This is 0. BCE will be equal to BCE. Right? So the point on x axis, that is point on BCE axis, will be BCE. Clear? Right? To get point on x coordinate, right? Point on which axis? Point on IC axis, put what 0?
BC.
Put the BCE is equal to 0. Okay? So, in equation 1, so what will that be if you put BCE is 0? IC will be BCC by RC plus RE, right? So let me take somewhere here. BCC by RC plus RE. Join these two. You know, straight line. Minimum 2 points, join the point you get. That's it. Right? So what is this line called as? DC loading. Okay? We took DC analysis. We took DC equivalent circuit. Right? Hence it is called as DC load line. Any doubts? Clear? Next, what we will do is, we will consider the complete circuit. Okay? For DC load line, we have taken the DC, okay? We have taken the DC equal. Next, what we will do is, we will take the complete circuit. Okay? Then we will discuss what we will get for, or what will be the AC. So far we have seen DC equivalent. Next time we will teach you what is AC equivalent. Same process. Any circuit you come across, the tricks you will use is the same. Okay? Anybody write this installation and fine. I will modify this. I will make the complete circuit. Okay. What is the trick we use for DC equivalent? Capacitor acted as DC equivalent. How did you get DC equivalent? Capacitor blocks DC. For AC equivalent, see for DC equivalent we have taken capacitor as open circuit. We got DC equivalent. For AC equivalent you will consider capacitor as short circuit. Simple. Okay. So first point for AC equivalent, I will write the points here.
Yes or no?
Yes.
I.
No.
Capacitor is acting as short circuit. Short circuit in parallel with the resistance. It is equivalent to short circuit. Okay? So will you have resistance?
No.
So directly this point connected here. Okay? Fine? Next. Collector. From collector, here you will draw RC. RC is connected from collector to ground, replacing VCC by ground. Okay? So RC I will connect from collector, okay? And in the case collector, so RC from collector to ground. Next, this capacitor acts as short circuit. So direct connection, right? To RL. RL already connected from collector to ground. Right? Clear? So again I am repeating, listen very carefully. Same trick I am telling you, same thing you will use next semester also, very important. Stop writing, listen very carefully, all of you. Okay, very important trick. Right? AC equivalent circuit. Murari, how to get AC equivalent circuit? What are the 2 points? Tell me. One is capacitor will act as short circuit. Next, replace. Any DC source is there, replace by ground. We have only one DC source, that will replace by ground. Next, so first capacitor is short. So actually here you are supposed to have real capacitor, real capacitor, okay? But that is short circuit. So VI directly connected to resistor. VI directly connected to R2 as it. R1 is starting from this point to VCC replaced by ground. Right? So R1 will start from base to ground. Clear? Actually R1 is from base to VCC. But when VCC is replaced by ground, R1 is from base to ground. So R1 is from base to ground. Clear? Right? R2 as it is base to ground. Okay? You can mark for note, you can mark like this. More than 2 lectures. You can mark like this. Okay? Okay. Next. What else we have here? Transistor. From transistor emitter, you have RE. In parallel with capacitor. Capacitor acts as short circuit, point number 1. So, RE in parallel with short circuit equivalent is short circuit. Means, emitter directly connected to ground. Clear? Next. Same logic. Why R1 is from base to ground? Same logic. RC will be from collector to ground. Because VCC replaced by ground. So RC from collector to ground. Next capacitor short circuited. So collector directly output terminal. Collector directly the output terminal. Right? Because the capacitor which was here, we have considered it as short circuit. Okay? Short circuit. RL as it is. This is the trick you will use for the AC equivalent. Clear? Okay? Please don't forget, very, very important. Now, we need not do the entire derivation. Okay? Logically, we can analyze the situations here. Okay? Next, think and tell me, very important. All of you, think and tell me. Why is it possible to M is plus C? That is possible, Arvind? Yes, sir. passes through R. Okay. What I am trying to say is, it is valid for the case any plot if it is. Say y is equal to x square or y is equal to mx plus c. Is it valid when x is equal to 0? You get a corresponding y value. Right? Okay? Using the same logic, we can understand the point through which the AC load line will pass. Okay? Right? Now listen to very carefully. What does this line indicate? This line indicates the possible values. Okay? Right? Means, if you adjust your circuit values such that, VC is VCC, then you are here. Okay? Means, you break the connection. For example, you break the connection here. Current is 0. When current is 0, then VCC becomes VCC. No drop across the resistance. Okay? Right? What I am trying to say is, depending upon the values of the circuit components, all the possible points is represented by this line. Okay? You open, you make IC 0, you are here. You make VCC 0, you make VCE 0, you make VCE 0, we are here. Clear? Okay? This represents all the possible values. Line represents all the possible values, point represents the fixed value. Okay? So we have already discussed operating point, DC operating point. Preferably in the center of the load line. Okay? Preferably in the center of the load line. What are the coordinates? X coordinate will be in terms of VCQ. So VCQ. Y coordinate will be in terms of IC. So ICQ. This will be the coordinates of the operating point. Now what we do? Okay. You fix VCC, you fix R1, RC, R2, RE. Okay? These are the components in the DC polarizer. Once you fix them, for example 12 volts, 100 kilo ohm, 10 kilo ohm, 2.2 kilo ohm, 1 kilo ohm. Right? Then the currents IC, voltage, VC will now be constant, fixed value. That is the point. Clear? What we do is, to that we give a sinusoidal input. Okay? That sinusoidal input, this circuit amplifies. Right? Okay? Then, I told you the oscillations will take place above the Q point. Clear? The oscillations will take place above the operating point. Now what I am trying to say is, when Vi is 0, okay, when Vi is 0, we didn't give any sinusoidal input. We are here. Clear? Right? The point I told you, we have an equation, it has to be valid when input is 0. Y is equal to mx plus c. Right? When x is 0, y is equal to c. So it is valid when input is 0 also. Clear? When input is 0, then you only have input is this. You only have the DC. Okay? And we are here. Clear? What I am trying to say is the AC load line will also pass through the operating point. Clear? Right? Because when input is zero, we are only in DC condition. Okay? Our equation should be valid for input is equal to zero also. Clear? Right? So keeping that in mind, the important point that we now understand is the AC load line will pass through what? Operating point. Clear? Okay? Anybody writing this? Raise your hand. So the important point.
Thank you.
See this circuit. Anakin is diode. All of you listen, it's very easy. Easy is calling. Anakin is diode, this is equivalent to what? It's a circuit. If I remove this diode, this is equivalent to which circuit? Fixed bias circuit. Okay? If I remove this, this is the DC current for fixed bias circuit. Simple. Put one diode. From there is a vacant place here. Put one diode. Okay? Right? Here what happens is, okay, so obviously remaining circuits, whatever you have as this. Okay? You can represent that this you explain sufficient. No problem. Okay? Here what happens? When temperature increases, what happens? IC naught will increase. IC naught doubles itself for 10 degrees rise in temperature. Okay? What is IC naught? Reverse saturation current. IC naught doubles itself for how many degrees temperature? Hello? IC naught doubles itself for how many degrees temperature? For every 10 degrees. Reason. What is the reason? This is simple. When temperature increases, okay, I told you, due to heat energy, electron hole pairs are formed, bonds are broken. I gave you an example. You are not able to break a rod. Heat the rod, you are able to break. So you can use heat energy to break bonds. Okay? Semiconductor, if you raise temperature, bonds are broken, you have excess charge carriers. So more the temperature, more the excess charge carriers. So more will be the leakage part. Simple? How can you forget this? Okay? Can you, are you able to forget, you are able to break the rod, you are able to leak, you are able to break off. So you can remember this. If you temperature increases, bonds are broken. Bond is broken means electron comes out of the bond. Okay? So you have excess minority charge carrier is affected. Majority charge, see, for a person who has 100 crores, if you give 1 lakh, doesn't make much difference. But a person has only 50,000, you give 1 lakh, makes a huge difference. So minority charge carrier count increases significantly. Clear? Everything remember, learn logically, you will never forget. Okay? So temperature increases, IC naught increases. Simple. If IC naught increases, okay, IC will, what will happen? Anybody see writing this part later? Finally, what will happen is this some current flowing. Now, the current which is drawn here is increasing. ID will increase. Okay? ID will increase. If ID increases, IC will decrease. Okay? So, this is how you have compensation for variations in IC now. Clear? Okay? We will continue in the next class. Okay? Lab. Tomorrow day after tomorrow you have labs. If you have passed, okay? You have only first semester results are declared. Earlier results I don't have in counseling books. So if you have cleared any areas, you please bring up to phone also, you show no problem. Get your counseling books updated. Clear? Right? Test 1, test 2 marks, again we will discuss during lab sessions. Assignment, again we will discuss. If your parent's phone number is updated, please let me know. Clear? Most probably by Friday, I may contact some of your parents. So please make sure all the counseling books are updated.